The former president was granted medical parole last month after spending 2 months in jail. This prayer event will also be graced by various churches and traditionalists. Let's cross live now to Simphiwe Makhanya, who is at the event. Simphiwe, have the people attending arrived already? What's happening?
Well, good morning to you, Desiree. Good morning to the viewers as well at home. As you are coming to us, Desiree, the stage is currently being set up for this prayer meeting here at People's Park next to Moses Mabhida Stadium. I'm going to step out of the shots, Desiree, just for our viewers to see the situation that is currently unfolding. I'm going to ask my colleague, Nomhle Ngubane, just to give you a sense of what is currently happening. Quite a few supporters of former President Jacob Zuma have started arriving here at People's Park in anticipation, of course, of the prayer meeting, which was scheduled to start at 10 a.m. This morning. But with me, I do have Mr. Nkosi Ntshashezi, who speaks on behalf of the RET forces. Thank you very much, Skananda, for your time. I can see already people starting to arrive. The event was scheduled to start at 10. Any delays?
Well, the event is going to start at any moment. I'm just happy by the turn up so far. You'd understand that the majority of people who support President Jacob Zuma are poor people who do not own any means of transport, who rely on public transport, and in many instances who do not even have 15 rand to pay for a taxi from the township to where we are today. So I am convinced that this is going to turn out to be what I term it as a black people's Christmas Day. It's a Zuma Day. We are here to celebrate after a horrible and horrific experiences that our father, the father of our revolution, has gone through.
How many people roughly are you expecting, Mr. Shez? Because if I look around, I can certainly tell you that the numbers are not looking good at the moment.
Well, I don't know the number of people that you are interested in. What does it have to do with the fact that black people in totality, except those that do not identify themselves as black, those who are, whose consciousness have been damaged by more than 300 years of slavery, but any conscious black person today is here with us and celebrating with us. They may not be here in physical, but even our forefathers, wherever they are, Abo Oliver Tambo, about Dr. Isaiah Pixelgasem, about Solomon Mahlangu, are happy today that people of this country are appreciating the enormous work, the selfless work that President Jacob Zuma is doing. And in fact, there is slightly a resounding call to see President Jacob Zuma ascend back to the throne, the highest office in the land. Because people are saying, in the absence of President Jacob Zuma, there is terror. When President Jacob Zuma is not there,
Sorry, Mr. Shez, where is that call coming from?
That call comes from ordinary men and women of this country, people like myself and yourself. You appreciate that 327 black lives did not matter, not to the government, not to the state president, not to any leader of the African National Congress today. People were butchered and they did not even bother to come and help and provide leadership.
Let me challenge you on that, Mr. Shez. The former president did have his time at the highest office in the country for 9 years serving this country as the president of the country. And I don't understand where this call comes from now after he finished his term, basically.
The call comes from the tears, the sorrows of mother whose three-year-old was butchered by Indian racist thugs in Phoenix, who were told by a man whom we are supposed to call him our leader that this, what is happening in the country, the dissatisfaction of the masses of our people at the manner in which President Jacob Zuma has been treated, it's just ethnic mobilization. And whenever such characterization has happened, you'd understand in the African continent that massacres follow. You'd understand that in Marikana, a certain descriptive was used to reduce a legitimate call by workers for fighting for for a living wage, to say that these are criminal elements. And what followed that is that the police unleashed brutality that has never been seen in the democratic state. And the same characters who were active in Marikan are the same characters who were active in Phoenix when our brothers and sisters were butchered. They carried no weapon. They say they protected property. Which property? Not even a single shop was burnt in Phoenix. But today we have leaders, so-called leaders of DA, who have audacity to celebrate thugs and criminality. We have a racist vision and his party that celebrates thugs. And it's a call to our people that you should reject them wherever you see them. You should make them run until they change and repent from their ways.
Are you expecting the former president to be here physically today?
I am expecting President Jacob Zuma to be here to give us a line of march. But in fact, President Jacob Zuma, in spite of all the pains, in spite of all the ill treatment that he has received from the ANC, he has made it clear that we had made, even in 1997, we made an analysis that ANC is a contested terrain. Should we leave the ANC as the forces of the left? We'll be leaving the ANC to the dogs. We'll be leaving the ANC to the open armors and the capitalists. And that we are not going to do. And therefore, as it painful as it is, as it sad as it is, we are calling upon the masses of our people to go in every municipality, in every ward across the length and breadth of South Africa, to vote for a resounding victory of the African National Congress. But also, we are calling upon our people to remove the inefficient NEC, to remove the inefficient president of the African National Congress. And it's time that President Jacob Zuma ascend to the position of president and lead us forward.
Mr. Shezi, thank you, Mama, for time.
Thank you, thank you.
Well, that's Mr. Kosen Shezi. He speaks on behalf of RET forces here in the province of KwaZulu-Natal, saying that they are expecting this prayer meetings to commence shortly, but all indications are that they are expecting more people to continue arriving here. I'm going to ask my colleague Nomhle Ngubane just to give you a sense of the number of people who are currently here at this venue. I'm going to step out of the shot just for a while and ask Nomhle Ngubane to give you a nice pen so that our viewers can see the amount or the number of people that are beginning to trickle in as they wait for the official program to commence. Desiree, over to you in Johannesburg.
Thank you very much there to Mr. Makhanya, and of